Hello everyone, welcome back with an interesting lecture on veterinary entomology. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss very briefly about Tsetse flies. First, I will discuss the morphological features, life cycle, feeding, distribution, and important species of different Tsetse flies. Later on, medical and veterinary importance of Tsetse flies will be discussed. If you want to get more video lecture on veterinary parasitology, including veterinary entomology, don't forget to subscribe the channel. So, let's get started. This is the zoological classification of different fly. You know, we study veterinary important arthropods under the suborder Nematocera, Brachycera, and Cyclohepa. You can see the different important families under the suborder Cyclohepa. In this video lecture, we're gonna study Tsetse fly under the family Glossinidae. Morphological features of a Tsetse fly. Tsetse fly are medium to large size, ranging 6 to 14 millimeter in length, excluding the length of proboscis. They are tan or brown in color. The fly has long and forwardly directed proboscis. Pulp of this Tsetse fly are also the size of proboscis. Remember that the base of the pulp is swollen. Antenna is arista type, three segmented antenna. The elongated third segment bears arista on dorsal side only, which is one of the unique features for these flies. Third antennal segment also bears fringe, which is absent in any other aristate flies. Eyes are dicoptic in both male and female flies. Wings of these flies are scissors-like at resting condition. They extend a short distance beyond the end of the abdomen. The wing can be differentiated from the wings of the flies based on medial discal cell, which is Butcher's clever shape or hatchet shape. However, sex differentiation can be done based on the presence or absence of knob-like appearance of hypopygium. In male flies, button or knob-like hypopygium is present on the ventral surface of the posterior abdomen. In female, it is absent. Life cycle of a Tsetse fly. Life cycle is like a typical dipteran flies. The developmental stages comprise larva, pupa, and adult. Mature female and male flies met together. It is interesting that once females are inseminated, they remain fertile throughout their life. After ninth day of mating, ovulation of a single egg occurs at a time. After fertilization, the fertilized egg move posteriorly to the uterus. Hatching occurs here in uterus after 4 days. The developing larva molt twice within the uterus to reach to larval stage 3 or third larval instar. The third larval instar occupies most of the female abdomen and about equal in weight to the rest of the female's body. Still, the female fly continue to suck blood progressively but in smaller amount. About ninth day of ovulation, fully developed third instar larva deposited on the ground by the female. It is noted that a well-nourished female will deposit third instar pupa at every 7 to 11 days of first larvae position, depending on the ambient temperature. Later on, the larva then quickly burrow soil up to 2.5 cm in depth. Within few hours of deposition on the soil, the larval integuments hardens and darken and become immobile brown to black puparium. Adult flies emerge about 30 days after the formation of puparium. Lifespan of a female tsetse fly generally 20 to 40 days, but it may reach even after 3 to 4 months. A male fly can survive only 3 to 4 weeks and typically mate only once or twice during their entire lifespan. Don't forget that the low reproductive rate of these flies is compensated by the extreme protection given by each larva by the female in their uterus. So this is all about life cycle of a tsetse fly. Feeding of tsetse flies. Both male and female are hematophagous, so both sexes will act as the vector of different diseases. Tsetse flies are distributed mostly in afrotropical region. Here you can see the distribution of major groups of tsetse flies in African continent. The important species of tsetse flies are also listed here. Public health importance of tsetse fly. Tsetse flies act as both mechanical and biological vector for different arthropod-borne or vector-borne diseases. This fly transmits the causal agent of human African trypanosomiasis or sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma brucei gambiensis causes Gambian sleeping sickness, and Trypanosoma brucei rhodesiensis causes Rhodesian sleeping sickness in human. According to the World Health Organization, Gambian sleeping sickness is found in 24 countries of West and Central Africa. It accounts for 92% of total cases and causes a chronic disease. Whereas Rhodesian sleeping sickness is found in 13 countries of Eastern and Southern Africa. It accounts for 80% of the total cases and cause an acute disease. It is also noted that the rural population who mostly depend on agriculture, fishing, animal husbandry, or hunting are the most exposed host for human African trypanosomiasis or sleeping sickness. Okay, sometimes you may be confused with American human trypanosomiasis or African human trypanosomiasis. Remember that American human trypanosomiasis is caused by Trypanosoma cruzi, but the vector is not the tsetse fly. Blood-sucking triatomine bugs transmit the infectious agent, and the disease is restricted in Latin America. Veterinary importance of tsetse flies. Tsetse flies transmit a number of Trypanosoma species that causes different diseases in different animals. Here you can see the causal agents, host affected, and for all of them, the vector is different species of Glossina. Maybe in some other video lecture, we will discuss in detail about these diseases listed here. So these are the reference material that I have used for the preparation of this presentation. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to share and subscribe this channel. Thank you so much and good luck for your studies.